Hi everyone and welcome back. And in this video we are again going to talk about use context hook. It will take some more videos to talk about it. Okay, so before understanding the context hook, we need to understand the context. Okay, so how this react.createContext APIs works in React, this is something new we have. Okay, so what we will do is we can actually create a context. We can just create a context.js. And in the context.js, we'll just import few things, React from React, and we'll create a context and we'll export it. Okay, export const, you can say shared context, and this context we are getting from React dot, there is a create context method, and it has some value, something. Okay, now we are going to, you can say const and then export default shared context. Okay, we will be using this context which we have created in our component. So this is app.js. Here we can import shared context from context. Okay, we got the shared context. Now what we need to do is we have to create a provider and consumer for our context. What we are trying to solve the problem from here is how we can actually pass the data from child to parent component. Okay, so here is our app component, const app. And what this app component is doing is it is returning something. Simple JSX. Consider that it is returning the child component. Okay, then we have a child component defined, same hierarchy we can build, and then it is rendering a grandchild component. I have created, because functional components are easy to create, so I have created all these functional components together, and here we have actually the finally, we are actually trying to print the value. Here I wanted to get the value from context, right? So I created a context. Now that context, I just need to create a providers and consumer for that shared context. So shared context I got from there. So in the app component, shared context dot provider. So I get provider here and I will get a consumer. So I need to just wrap my child component inside that provider so that this context can be shared with all the children this app component is having. Okay, child component is a children, then there is a grandchild, and here I wanted to access the values which you are setting from there, right? In this provider, what I'm setting is just some value, right? And I wanted to access this context in the child component. In the grandchild component, there may be another layer, right? So how can I access? I will be using the hooks here, which is like const value. Why this const value equal to use context, and I will be just passing the context, shared context here, because from shared context only we are able to get this context. So here I got this context, and here I can return the simple value. So in this context we just have this value, right? Now what I want is I want to pass this value to child, to grandchild, to anywhere, right? The only precondition is you will create a shared context and you will wrap your child component in the provider passing that value here. So this value can be accessed now to any layer of child component, maybe a child, grandchild, or further great grandchild. Okay, so what we need to do, wherever you wanted to consume the data, you have to use context to provide the shared context. So now this context, once you provide this, this component should be able to access whatever has been set in the provider context. Okay, This is very simple example. There may be a complex example. You can set anything here. It's not like you can set only string value. You can set an object or an existing state. This child component will be calling directly a method which will update the state of this app component. Something like this, const, we have count and set count. Okay, it is using use state. So this is existing state we have. Now what you are doing, you are directly passing these two properties. So currently, let's say I'm just passing count. So I can directly access the count here, the value, because the value has only count. Okay, so the use case is, there are different use cases of this. First of all, we are able to remove this props drilling problem. Child component would be able to directly call the method of the parent component. It doesn't need to traverse the whole path of all the components which are coming in between. We are creating a shared context. That context is being shared by all the components. Okay, here it can be an object. So let's say I have an object, and where I have username hello. Okay, if I wanted to access it, then it would be simple, use value dot dot username, it's in caps, right? You just set this property and we are passing this property to the child component and we are able to access it. So you can, there are many use cases of use context hook. Here you can create this object, and you can also have some kind of a method. You can also pass these methods which can be triggered directly from the child component, so that parent component will get the updated state. So we have a count and set count, right? So what these are two different methods, but you can trigger these methods from child component and you can update the state directly. Okay, so this is very basic example. In the next video, we will extend this example and we will include more things.